The following program is brought to you in living color on NBC.
It's great to be in Miami to recognize our honorees. What do they stand for? They stand for integrity. They stand for commitment. And they stand for involving Jewish men in Jewish life. They never say no. They always raise their hands. And they believe in what they're doing. They won't back down. No,
to me, it's really trying to remember what our people have gone through, trying to remember of what I'm trying to give my own kids and what hopefully their kids will remember about what it is. Just even if you just call yourself a Jew, which is really important, because in this world today, that in itself is a very difficult thing.
I think that some of the challenges that are forthcoming include inclusion, and we're going to be challenged with that. We're going to have to learn how to do a better job of that. I think we're going to have to learn how to make ourselves relative to the next generation, and how to reach out to more people. We're ready for the challenge. I'm not sure we have all the answers yet, but one of the good things about these kinds of conventions is we can come together and share our successes.
It's not easy. It's some days it's tougher than others. I am probably what would be called the traditional conservative Jew. And I know that sometimes I have points of view that are different than the traditional or than others in the conservative movement. I think it's important, though, that we all remember that we are Jews and we have to get together. We have to work together, because if we don't, we're all in trouble.
I think that Jewishness has been such a critical part of my life and my family's life. And I think that people often don't realize how important it is, both culturally and spiritually, to be Jewish. Because the lives they lead are somewhat different than the lives that I led when I was that age. And it's trying to figure out how we can get that message across, and not just get the message across, but actually get people involved in being Jewish.
I can't look at the world except with Jewish eyes and Jewish values. I am who I am, and I'm a Jew. That's how I interpret everything. That's how I see everything. And sometimes it gets to me, and sometimes it doesn't. But when I go to the source of what I think, what I read, and what I know, I tend to look at the Jewish world in the Jewish eyes, and sometimes I'm drawn back to the religious sources.
I'm a dentist. I practice where 98% of my patients are not Jewish. And I think that in this today's society that you have to always treat people with a certain thought in the back of your mind that you are Jewish, and that how you treat these people reflects not only on you, but on the entire religion, and that you must treat them ethically and morally correct. And I think that's an important thing.
All I can say is I love being Jewish. We have a really good thing going, and it's just wonderful that it's starting to be acceptable in the world. It's wonderful that it's recognized. It's wonderful that we're in positions of leadership throughout the country, throughout the world, and I'm proud to be Jewish.
Well, for me, primarily service. Capital letters, bold type. It's what our men's club does. We serve the community, we serve the synagogue, we serve each other. And once in a while, we serve drinks. And
what's the first word that comes to my mind when I hear men's club? Friendship.
Friendship. I have met so many people, whether it's in my club, my region, any of these Jewish events, convention, retreats, LDI. I can go almost anywhere in this country and pretty much pick up the telephone, call somebody up, say, I'm here.
Achav, which is the Hebrew for brotherhood. And in Hebrew, it has the connotation of camaraderie, social interaction, trust, respect, and liking.
Teamwork and camaraderie. Our guys work together great. And when someone tells one of the guys, you know, what a great job that person has done, everybody says it's teamwork. It's not just one person. And so it's really nice.
Brotherhood. The men's club has provided the chance for brotherhood for me with my fellow men's club guys in both my club and throughout FJMC. And that, for me, is what makes it, makes me complete within the men's club in FJMC.
Our slogan, involving Jewish men in Jewish lives, that's really the major thrust. And I think camaraderie really is what would sum it all up.
Well, when we joined the synagogue back in the mid-1970s, we were invited to join a Havarah. And everybody in the Havarah was very much involved in the a synagogue, either on the board or in the men's club. And so it's just natural that I would be invited to the men's club, my wife would be invited to join the women's league, and so we've been active in the synagogue ever since.
Joining a men's club gives you an opportunity to make new friends, get involved with Jewish activities, and find people with similar interests to help you grow both as a man and as a Jewish man.
Men's club at Meishel is the place where all the action is. We're the guys who get things done. We're the guys who have some fun. We're the guys who actually think about things that matter to Jewish men, and we're a place to set some roots.
One of the guys I used to go diving with, who used to go diving with us, I should say, scuba diving, was president of the men's club. And he said, Neil, come to a meeting. Come, you'll get involved, you'll enjoy it, it'll be good for you. I said, he says, and there's other guys like me, you know, and we'll all go diving together. That's all he had to say to me, you know, that was enough. And sure enough, you know, I came to a meeting, and it wasn't too many months later that I was nominated to be secretary, you know, that's the way it works. You know, people get brought in, and it's been a love affair. Pretty much.
Mama Ginsburg was one of the founders of Sisterhood. Her husband was a professor of Talmud at JTS, and she had the expression, people volunteer for people who volunteer. So if you ask someone to come and help with to do, then they tend to do. And then you tend to recruit them, and they tend to like it and like to be with these people. So you always ask, would you like to join us? Will you help me?
First, Keruv. which is outreach to our non-Jewish brethren, and trying to reach out and bring them in to our synagogues, not necessarily conversion, but just outreach and trying to be close with them so that they feel part of the community. That, I believe, is a very strong point of FJMC. It really shows what we are able to do lay-led, very lean and mean in our main office, and it's a program that we were able to quickly get out to the men's clubs across the world.
The Worldwide Rap, which is teaching conservative Jewish men and women to lay tefillin. That's an important part of it. My father taught me to lay tefillin when I was 2 weeks before or 3 weeks before my bar mitzvah, and I have been laying tefillin ever since.
Yellow candles, Yom HaShoah. It serves a number of purposes, education and remembrance. And I think those two things are really what we're all about at FJMC. We're providing service to survivors. We're providing service to honor the memories of those who were lost. And we're teaching.
About, I don't know how many years ago, there were five men's clubs in Cleveland. And we got together and we put together a Hebrew literacy program that involved literally hundreds of people, both teachers and students. It was a lot of work to do it. It took a lot of planning, but the results were fantastic. And to this day, I see some of the students, some of the teachers, and they all had a really positive experience.
There's so many great programs, but more and more I'm saying hearing men's voices, because when you have guys sitting down together talking about something that they don't normally talk about. I grew up in a house, my father was wonderful, but he wasn't a talker. Having the opportunity to talk and express things about issues that are really personal and relevant, what could be better?
I believe that my involvement has given me more self-confidence, for sure. More knowledge. I've learned quite a bit. I've educated myself in other ways along the road about the same time, but Men's Club became a significant piece of it.
Well, as a rabbi, my answer may differ from the rest of the guys. I'm a firm believer in Hamavdil Ben Kodesh L'Chol, making a distinction between the holy and the secular. For many of the guys, the holy may be coming together for men's club. For me, the men's club events are more of the secular. I enjoy going to the ball games with the guys, and I enjoy camping out with the guys, or just meeting for breakfast. Whatever it is that we do, we make sure to do it in a Jewish way. We make sure to include something Jewish. And I mean, even if we're going to go to a baseball game in the evening and just have a good time and drink beer, we're going to first assemble for a minyan, and we're going to daven together. And maintaining our Jewishness, of course, becomes a big part of my role. But I enjoy it from both a holy and a secular perspective.
I'm very comfortable speaking in front of people now, comfortable speaking in front of large groups of people, comfortable speaking outside the country, delivering sermons, the ability to lead people, skills that I never could have acquired in business and things that have helped me dramatically in my life. And somebody that becomes active in Brotherhood, they can acquire those skills. I am no different, certainly no better, absolutely no brighter than anybody else out there.
We have a daily minyan. And they are always looking to have people come in to make a minyan. And they asked me, and I said, well, okay, can you become a member of the minyan and so forth? I said, okay, fine. And it was really in this kind of minyan that I began to learn a lot of the details, you might say, of how service is performed. And I've just gotten, from there I became the principal shamus handing out the honors and so forth.
I have become more aware spiritually. It became more of an issue when I started saying Kaddish, first for my mother and then for my father. I think with my father, it was timing was everything. He passed away 2 weeks after I retired at the young age of 101, and with me every day. And I started, went to shul every day saying Kaddish. The year was up. What am I going to do? I can keep going. I don't have to go to work. I don't have to do this. I don't have to do that. And shul became almost the number one thing in my life.
Men's Club has helped me in so many ways and given me confidence to do things that I never would have done before I got involved in the Men's Club. Sitting there, even just something as simple as getting up at a Friday night dinner and leading the beer cot. When I first joined the Men's Club, you couldn't have gotten me to do that for all the tea in China. Now, yeah, sure, if you don't mind me singing off tune a little bit, I'll be glad to do it. But it's just that confidence building and ability to participate more fully, both at the synagogue and rituals and family traditions we observe at the home.
I didn't know squat about Jewish liturgy. I didn't know squat about Jewish ritual until about 15 years ago. I was at the first retreat I had attended, the New England Region Retreat, where some guy named Bob Braitman, who I didn't know at all, was running something called a Learner's Minion. And Bob had this little cheat sheet, piece of paper about 2 inches wide and 8 inches long that explained the services. And he said, tuck it into your Sim Shalom. Now let's talk and look. Every service is alike. There's an order to it. Everything's the same day in and day out. We sing it a little differently. We add a few things here and there. But I knew nothing. FGMC changed that. I know a little more than nothing.
Well, I think that after this week, it'll probably be Miami Beach 2015. Receiving the Masim Tovim Award is quite an honor. I'm thrilled to be here for this. Coming back to Miami, where I grew up, where I went to yeshiva here. And but prior to 2015, I would say I'm not sure how I could top the sweat hut, the infamous sweat hut at Camp Ramah, where our guys go for our southeastern retreat each year in February in the middle of the winter. And we all climb into that sweat hut and just have a really, really good time.
The Cantus concert was my first convention last year, Danvers. And I've never, ever experienced anything like that in my whole life. The feeling of 500, 600 men, women singing together these songs with cantors and the spirit that came out of it was overwhelming. And part of that was that Friday night service. Friday night services many times are very dry. You come there because it's your tradition, it's your commitment to the community, you go there. But after seeing that, I said, how can we bring that to us?
One of the things that's really been terrific about conventions is the ruach, the spirit that goes on during convention, and how that translates into activities during throughout the whole year for anybody who participates in convention. I think when you're here, there's a certain liveliness and a certain camaraderie that just transfers over for a long period of time.
After 12 conventions, they're all memorable. There's no especially one. I think what I really remember is when I was the first time Dr. Ron Wolfson spoke. And he didn't just speak, he greeted us as we walked into the auditorium. And they said, this is the way you ought to be greeting your congregants. And he still talks that way.
The convention experience I remember most was being regional president. We held the convention in the Chicago area. And at the start of the convention, we all came in dressed up as the Blues Brothers. And I felt so wonderful sitting there leading a swell group of guys into a convention and just having a great time at the convention, opening up and setting a tone for the rest of that convention?
I think our cooking program, which is our source of fundraising, we have a great group of guys that come in when we're asked to do a kiddush, come in and prepare the kiddush, and the camaraderie that we experience in that process. Guys working together, preparing the food, getting it ready, serving the food, getting it out. We get lots of compliments.
My first men's club convention, which I was kind of strong-armed into attending, became a really outstanding experience. I found that I could sit in a hotel lobby and chat with the international president, we may have called him national at the time, president of the organization, and other high-level leaders of this group, comfortably, with no animosity. It was just everybody was one of the guys. You didn't have to be involved forever. You didn't have to be one of the leaders. I, as a newcomer, was able to one-on-one talk with these guys, and it so impressed me that kept me coming back.
My best men's club memory is having my arm twisted to go to my first retreat and showing up at the retreat. I was promised there would be no lecture police, there would be no service police, there would be no participation police. I was told to go and have fun. I did, and I'm here 15 years later. Hey, yeah. We'll stay.